arts, people. Somebody sent me this horse movie scene, and it's kind of interesting to look at the writing for good and bad, but let's take a look at it, and I'll stop it and pause it and talk about what I'm seeing. So, as these people writing, I want you to watch for the open mouths, the heads up, because they're being pulled on, and the different writing positions. So here we go. So you notice the horses are kind of side straddling and sidestepping and kind of slow, and all these horses are running up. I've talked about riding with open and wild herds, and if you've never done it, it's really a pretty cool experience. But anytime you get horses running in a herd, all horses want to run. No horse wants to be last. No horse wants to be on the outside. So you have this gathering and pooling effect of the horses. So it's a constant fight to keep your horses from herding up. So just because you can ride a horse and control a horse like these guys, if you get in a wild herd, now these horses all have riders, so they're all being controlled a little bit. But if you ever run with like 50, 100 horses that are loose and you're running, you know, for a mile or so with them and they're just running, especially at night, man, it's pretty difficult. I mean, to me, I rode Tanner and Lakota both with the wild herds like that. And it's usually easier just to give them their head and let them run with the herd. And you just be a good rider and stay out of his way. But these horse riders are going to be really in these guys' way because they're trying to control their speed and slow them down. And they're using bits and pain to do it because that's what bits and pain does. So these guys are kind of prancing and dancing because they're slowing them down. The other horse behind them. And I don't think none of these horses are really running at like what I would call full speed. They've all kind of hold back. There's one scene where they kind of let the horses go. So you have horses with yelling, you have herd, you have riders, and you have pain, and you have flame that they're carrying. Anybody that thinks this is like easy, it's easy when you have pain bits to control the horse and you keep them in constant pain. And that's how most movies are. I mean, it's kind of sad the way it is, but that's the way it is. So obviously you're probably riding in a car or something. Look how many horses they have in the scene. I mean, this is like a huge. Remember, this is back in the when a scene called for a horse to be killed, they would actually kill it on scene, live. They would use a real bullet and kill the horse on scene. So you notice the horses' heads are high. They don't really have their head. You'll see horses. These horses are at a pretty good sprint. These horses are going fast. These horses are being held back. You can tell by their feet when the horse is, this horse being held back. Look at that head. Look at that head. Look at the heads being pulled in pain. Trying to control these horses. Mouths open. Heads sideways. Horses should always be running with their head straight and following their head. Anytime you see a horse with their head up high like this and turning, there's not a lot of communication. There's force and fear controlling these horses. Force, fear, and pain. Heads up. Horses are running in fast from different angles, yelling, screaming, dust. You can't see. We have dust in a horse's eyes, yelling and waving things on top. I don't know how many horses are in this scene, but there's a lot of freaking horses. And I'm telling you, when you get this herd horse mentality, it's even harder to control. Look at this guy's leg way up. He's leaning back. His legs are up, bouncing. Mouth pulled back. Mouth pulled back. I mean, it's just amazing when people look at horses like, wow, look at those horses. That's cool. Wow, look at those riders. And nobody, unless you're a horseman, really looks at how the horses are being controlled and being pain controlled through the scene. Mouth up, head up, head, mouth, ouch, big pain, big bits, ouch. Look at that head right there. Look at that, ow, 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 pain. In these scenes like this where you're running, if a horse stumbles, trips, falls, a horse bumps a rider gets off balance and pulls the bit and takes the horse's head because he's falling, and he rips the horse's head to the side, the horse will fall, and you have a huge injury for horses that trip over him, for riders. I mean, these scenes were pretty dangerous back in the day, because it was just, horses were expendable. So what if a horse is getting hurt or killed? We got a bunch more. Go get another horse. Who cares? Let's get the scene. See, mouth up, open, foam, pain, horse not following his head, horse is trying to avoid pain because he's trying to slow him down. Watch the horse's head. Watch the horse's head up. This means pain. Ouch! Ouch! You're pulling so hard. No horse runs like this. Why? Because this horse can't see in front of him. A horse's head has to be like this to see in front of him. When a horse does this, he's running blindly. He's much more likely to trip. That's why when you give an inexperienced rider, like I told him my story while Buddy gave his wife said, this horse doesn't stop. I need a bigger bit. He gave her a bigger bit. She went out there, pulled on the reins, and the horse flipped over on her because she didn't understand the power of pain. And she didn't know how to give the horse release. And she thought the horse didn't listen to her because she didn't have enough pain. So the husband foolishly gave her a bit with more pain, and she caused the horse to flip over and hurt her. And then later he's like, I should have never gave her that bit. She didn't know how much pain she was creating. She didn't know how to give release. Yeah, that's why bits aren't good. That's why you don't give inexperienced riders bits and pain bits, and you never blame the bit for not being able to control your horse. Mouth up, pain, pain pulling, ouch, ouch, ouch. Lots of horses, lots of dust, more horses coming in the background. Look at this horse's mouth. These right here is where they open these horses up. You can really see when the horses open up because they're being controlled, they're being held back, and now all of a sudden they're giving their head. And these horses go into overdrive. This horse is being held back. Overdrive, full speed. Now they start trying to break away. And all horses, if you get them in this pack, they will all try to run full speed, fear, panic. You incite a flight and fear response, and their instinctual reaction is to run very fast as they can. Horses run when they're scared of something. They don't run because they're fun. When you have a herd of horses running, they're thinking fear. Something's chasing us. Danger. Run as fast and stay in front of the herd so you don't get picked off. So you're constantly holding a horse back when you're running or riding with horses that are running in a herd. Man, lots of horses. I like this guy's, this one scene right here. This one is a good scene. When you talk about heels down, this guy's got his heels down, right? His heels are freaking down. If your heels down, your butt's down. I saw another one with the hills were coming in. He was way up over the horse's head. Lots of horses. Big, huge horse scene. I just thought it was kind of a cool video, and I figured I'd discuss some things on when I see horses in movies. Those are the things I look for. All right? We'll end that there. Y'all have a good one.